Hi everyone and welcome to Battle of the Band. My name is Bean and we're on day 36 of the Butthole Surfers tournament. So it's going to be kind of an interesting matchup today. I was made aware recently that there are actually two Butthole Surfers tracks called something, and I only put one in my tournament. And I don't know which one's in the tournament because there's two of them called something. So I guess I'm just going to have to listen to both songs and decide which one's better. Although one is kind of technically partially a cover. So the first one is off of the Butthole Surfers self-titled debut EP from 1983. And that one is fully original. That's a Butthole Surfers track. But then the other one is from 1991's PO'd. And that actually has the lyrics from the original something. So, and at that rate, it's just a remake of a song. But it has music by the Jesus and Mary Chain, which was a Scottish... They got back together recently. They actually had an album recently. But they're a Scottish kind of like noise pop band. Their song, Never Understand, is what the music of the song will be. So I decided, let's just go ahead and listen to both of them, see which one's better, and let that one go up against the other competitor today, which is Yentl, off of 2001's Weird Revolution album, which was their last album. I don't have any extra factoids on Yentl, really. It's a weird one. It's just kind of, there's no lyrics. I remember that. There's a sample that's in another language that I don't speak or understand. I'm sure if somebody knows what they're saying down there, that'd be helpful. I looked it up on genius.com and it just has characters with no translation. If I were to guess, I mean, it's Asian, but I'm not sure what language exactly. It's kind of like kanji, but I don't know if that's kanji. I don't know these languages very well or at all. I just speak one language. I'm dumb like that. So, first up, I think what I want to do is just go ahead and play Jesus and Mary Chain, Never Understand, to see where they got the musical side of that version of something. So this is Jesus and Mary Chain, Never Understand, off of their debut album, Psycho Candy. Let's be real, I just wanted to listen to some of the Jesus and Mary Chain. That's a great band. If you haven't heard Psycho Candy, go and listen to that album. If you're into 80s noise rock, 80s noise pop, if you're into shoegaze, if you're into dream pop, just check out Jesus and Mary Chain. So fucking good. So yeah, that's the musical basis for the Butthole Surfers' second version of the song Something. So let's just go ahead and do that one next, since it'll blend into the next song, which will be the original, right? Right. Ooh, that's high pitched. My right ear's been a little fucked up lately, and that was really fucking with it. That was cool though. Yeah, that definitely has the same vibe as Never Understand from Jesus and Mary Chain. Super cool, like, sounding song. Let's see what the original Something is like. Bound to sound completely different. All right, Beatles from 2 days ago. That is how you do a song about domestic violence. That was really the lyrics are about. I mean, they're, I think they're meant to be funny, but they're about kicking. They're like about kicking his girlfriend in the teeth or whatever. And by whatever I mean his girlfriend or his wife or whoever she is, but it involves kicking her in the teeth. I don't know. It was 1983, and it seems like it's supposed to be meant to be kind of a humorous interpretation of, like, you know, that typical, like, lower class American household life where you imagine the, you know, the overweight, beer swilling, Texan dude, because they're from Texas, you know, so they're thinking like a big fat redneck, basically, like, you know, someone that looks like Bill from King of the Hill, but not nice, like Bill from King of the Hill. He's like a big old jerk. There's families like that, I guess. It's not great to make fun of them, but the song itself was really good. Like the saxophone, the guitars, the just everything about it was fucking amazing. I hesitate to use the word amazing, but I mean, it was everything I like in music. That's what I like. I like that. It's just the most simple way of putting it, I guess, is the best way. Simple and best. Simple and good. Like, next up is Yentl on Weird Revolution 2001. It's not gonna beat fucking something. Oh, and yeah, I'm gonna give that one to the original something. That's a far superior song. The one on Piode is fun and everything. Pretty sweet to listen to. The Psycho Candy song is, I mean, the Jesus and Mary Chain song off of Psycho Candy is better at that sound, I guess, but something off of their first EP is so good. Shit. All right, Yentl, good luck. It just does this for 3.5 minutes.
Yeah.
I mean, that's one I would skip all the time back then, even. Yentl being what Yentl is, it's not really a song. It's just kind of a piece of interlude. It's all right. It's something you can move your head to. You can chill out to it. You can groove to it. It's not going to win this tournament. Something has a chance of getting pretty far in this tournament, though. That song was fucking rad. So we're going to give that to Something off of the self-titled Butthole Surfers EP. Even with its very problematic lyrics, like, it's not really that funny these days. Back then, it was just a cartoony, funny thing for them, you know? Like, I could imagine, you know, I could just imagine the cartoony, like, redneck family idea they had in their head, and, you know, none of the violence is real, right? I don't know. I don't know. Let's give that Something. It's far superior to Yentl. Anyway. I'm meandering. If you'd like to talk to us, give us some of your feedback. You can hit us up on our social media. We've got some Instagram set up. We got some of that Twitter action over there and a little bit of that Facebook page shit going down. So be sure to check all that stuff out. I do link the songs down below so you can listen to those on your own. I'll link that the Jesus and Mary Chain song as well down there. So be sure to click that and be sure to listen to Psycho Candy if you haven't. That album will make your day. Like this video if you like this video. Subscribe if you want to subscribe to the channel and support me if you like seeing me succeed. And if you'd like to see me get a better channel URL, that's the goal right here, 100 subscribers. Share this video if you'd like to share the video, and maybe you don't want to subscribe, but you're cool sharing. I don't know what you want to do, man, but just do you. Comment down below, all of you, every single one of you, please comment down below and let me know what your choice would have been if you were in the hot seat. You could also hit up our Instagram. You can vote on there too. There's a little clicky button in the story. You can vote on which one you think is the best one. Kind of like to describe the concept of the video, but if you're still hanging out and you don't know what the hell you just watched, this is a battle of the band thing. We take all the songs from a band and we make them fight each other in a tournament until there's one left winning. Until there's one winner left. Huh. I should have put that at the beginning of the video. Anyway, I hope you all have a great night, a wonderful afternoon, and a decent morning. I'll see you all in just a few minutes for the Beatles. We've got a pretty short one for them today. Bye! Oh, balls. Let's be real, I just wanted to listen to hold on, phone's ringing. Yeah, loop. Yeah. Okay, see you soon.